Hi, this is Toby with HMC Electronics. Today we're going to be taking a look at the new Edsyn 951SXe. Anyone who is familiar with the Edsyn line is familiar with the Edsyn 951SX. This unit has been a top-selling, top-performing station of theirs for years, if not a decade. They have made some improvements to it, they've listened to customer feedback, and the 951SX will slowly but surely be phased out, and they've already released the new version, which is the 951SXe. So here it is, the 951SXe, a slightly different design as you can see, a lot smaller footprint, which is very, very important as we see work areas, workstations get smaller, operators working closer together, so bench space being more valuable. A few things worth noting. If you've got the LT series tips, the tips that you were using with your 951SX, don't worry, you can continue to use those in the new 951SXe. Tips, the LT series, are all interchangeable between units. Has the same heater coil assembly, so you're still putting out 95 watts of power. So you've got an excellent station for leaded applications, lead-free applications, as well as applications with heavy heat sinks and things where it might be a higher capacity or a higher drain on that iron. One of the things that I don't like about this unit, and I don't think it's a major design flaw, in fact, it's very easily addressed, is how they've done this modular sponge tray. It's kind of hidden under here. What I look at this more as is this is pretty much a storage compartment, if you will, and then rather than using these old style cellulose sponges, using and picking up the Edsyn EA439, which is one of these wire sponges for tip cleaning. We've seen a huge number of these sold in every iteration. Weller, Hacker, Meckel, all of them have them. But the Edsyn EA439 is a great buy. So what makes this an SXE? Why is this an SXE or a sexy station? And I think that's what Edsyn was going for with that, that part numbering system. And there it is. And in fact, actually, I will turn down these lights so you can actually see what makes this such a sexy station. One second. And there it is. The Edsyn 951SXE has electric blue LED lighting. Used to be reserved only for nightclubs and 90s raves. You've now got this awesome blue lighting, which I just think is pretty cool. While I'm looking at it like this, you can probably see this blinking light that is slowly pulsing right now. That is actually telling you the heating element is on. If you turn up the temp, it'll blink very, very, very fast. That's telling you that it is getting up to temp. And then as soon as it is at that new temperature, it will go back to its slow blinking. One of the things that is often overlooked when people are looking at the Edsyn station, the 951SX, and I'm sure the SXE will have the same oversight, is that it is a 95 watt soldering iron, not the power supply. The iron itself is putting out 95 watts of power. Feel free to browse the internet, browse our website, hmcelectronics.com, and you'll see there aren't that many stations that are putting out that much power. Now take into account the price point on this station. The 951SX was about $130, $140. 951SXE is about $150. There aren't any. There are no other stations on the market putting out this much power at this price point. Now let's look at cost of ownership. If you were then to find a station that had some power that was comparable, 80 watts, 85 watts, 90 watts even, take a look at how much those soldering tips cost, and you will see that most of them cost around $10, if not $12, $13. The Edsyn 951SXE takes the LT series of tips. So for example, an LT375 tip, it's going to cost you less than $5. So when you're looking at the total cost of ownership for a soldering station, what it's going to be costing you the weeks and months and years after you've bought that station, take a look at the tip cost, take a look at the station cost, add it all up, and you'll see that 951SXE, like its predecessor, the 951SX, is a great deal for a very high-powered station. If you have any questions on the Edsyn 951SXe, the old Edsyn 951SX, or any of the Edsyn line, feel free to pick up the phone, give us a call, drop us an email. We'll be happy to help. Thanks very much for watching, and happy soldering.